Hey guys, Balkan Architect here, and in today's video I'm going to be showing you how to create a 3D detail in Revit. Not only how to isolate a 3D detail in Revit, a part of your construction, but also to peel back some of the layers to show off what that detail is made out of and to show as much information as possible, because that's the whole idea of creating detailing. Now, I'm creating this video for a couple of reasons. The first reason is I think this is really cool. I think it's really useful and I wanted to share it with you. And the second reason is, well, I'm promoting my course. I have a whole detailing masterclass in Revit. It's a course where I show you everything you need to know about detailing in Revit. It's available on my website, balkanarchitect.com. It's going to be the first link just below this video, and then also it's going to be up there in the cards, so check it out if you're interested. Okay, so without any further ado, let's jump into Revit. And here we are in Revit, and as you can see, the first step that we're going to take, and this is the most important step, and that's to make sure to hit that like button and make sure to subscribe. Not only does it help to promote the video to other people that might want to see it, and also to remind you when I upload new content, but also it makes the alpaca happy, and that's why we're all here. Okay, now let's move on with the tutorial. So here you can see I have this office building, and this is what I'm going to be using to show off how to create this detail. And the first step is obviously to create a new view for our 3D detail. So you want to go here to the project browser, you want to go down to 3D views, and then what I'm going to do here is right click on the 3D view. I'm going to go to duplicate view, and it's going to create a new view. Now you want to right click here and then go to rename, and let's call this one our 3D detail. Okay, and now yeah, that view is opened up here, so we can close off the original 3D view. Now in order to kind of isolate one specific part of our model in order to show the detailing, what we have to do is use the section box tool. Now that's available here in the properties panel for the view properties. So when it says 3D view, or when nothing is selected in the view, here you get your 3D view properties, and if I scroll down under extents, you get a section box. So for this, you just check the section box on, and then you hit apply, and this is what's going to happen. It's going to show your section box. Now, what you want to do now is, well, use the section box to kind of carve out the detail that you want to show. Now, in this case, for this particular building, I think it would be cool to show the detail here in this part of the building. Here we have this connection, or perhaps let's... yeah, we can even do this side here. So where we have a connection between the actual wall and then the curtain wall and then the roof as well. I think it's a nice little detail there, nice little connection. So we want to show that off. So let's do that. I am just going to be pulling this in a little bit like so. Okay, that's a bit too much. So that could work. Pull this in on the other side. There we go. Then pull this closer. Pull this closer in here as well, and now we want to slide this one up. So it's basically like kind of playing around with this little cube, and then you can show your detail. And as you can see, this is getting fairly good. We do have a lot of elements showing. Perhaps move this up a little bit. There we go. And then obviously from the upside, you can move that down, but it's not that necessary. Now, one additional thing that you might want to do is to turn off the visibility of your levels. So, oops, yeah, let's bring it here where you can see it, where my head isn't blocking it. So you have this level, it's useful in the 3D view, but in this particular case, I don't think it makes too much sense. So let's just select that and then go to the view panel, go to the little hide in view light bulb, and then just click on hide in view. Okay, now it's hidden and it looks much better. Now also, I suggest you select the section box and you give it the same hide in view treatment. So you go here to hide in element, and then it's hidden. And if at any point you want to resize that section box or bring it back to life, well, you can simply go down here, find your little light bulb, reveal hidden elements, and then it's going to show both that and this level here. and you can just select it and you have unhide here. Obviously we don't need that now, so let's uncheck that. Now here we seem to have some sort of an element that's visible, but I don't know exactly what it is and I don't particularly care for it, so let's go and hide that as well. So anything that you don't like, anything that you think is taking away from the view and not showing any useful information, make sure to hide that. Okay, the next step is to perhaps fix these issues here with these joins. So as you can see, this looks like it hasn't been joined correctly. So for that, you just go to the Modify tab, you go to the Join Geometry panel, and then you go to the Join Geometry tool. So you just click here, you click this, and it's connected. I think we can do the same thing here with the beam and the floor. There we go. And now everything looks nice. Also here, for some reason, the ceiling seems to be escaping to the outside. That looks odd. So you can go to Edit Boundary and you can see why that is. Oh, it's all the way down there. Well, we can go to a top view. Let's see. Yeah, this should definitely stop here. There we go. Hit finish. And now if we orbit around, yeah, that looks way more correct. So there you go. This is how you create your 3D detail view. Okay, so now the next step is going to be obviously to peel back the layers, as I said, and we're going to be doing that by selecting one of these elements, and keep in mind that not all elements are going to have this ability. So you select one of the elements, and then as you can see, for example, for this roof here, we don't have the ability to create parts. So what you want to do in this case is go to this shape editing panel and then go to reset shape. Now in this case it makes sense to just say that here, as you can see, it's going to delete some dimensions, and you don't want to do this in case you have a file that's important to you. So perhaps copy the original file before starting to create your 3D details. So just something to keep in mind. Okay, anyways, and now once we have reset the shape in the shape editing, now here on the create panel, we do get the create parts tool. So once you click on the create parts tool, it, as you can see, it separates all of the parts, and now we can edit them. So what I like to do is use the divide parts, and for this, as you can see, we have to edit the sketch, and it's going to show the sketch here kind of below the model. So what you want to do is navigate here to the top, like so, and then I'm just going to use a straight line and just cut through this. Hit the escape key a couple of times. Let's move it a bit closer in, like that perhaps. Yeah, there we go. And then you hit finish again, and now, as you can see, these are two separate parts. Now you can select this one, and you can just go here to exclude parts, and that's going to, well, make that one disappear. So it kind of starts to peel back the layers. Then you can go to the next one. In this case, I think it's this one. So again, you can go to divide parts, edit sketch. So again, I would go to the top of the view, and then you just repeat the process just a little bit towards the outside like that. You hit finish, orbit back around, you select that element, and then you exclude that part as well. And there you go. So that's how you basically kind of start peeling back the layers. If I just go here to graphic display options, let's see, for shadows, ambient shadows, perhaps just crank it up a little bit. There we go. So you can start playing around with these and just see what works best, which view, perhaps a shaded view or a consistent colors or even realistic could do the job, and you can make this look really, really good. And obviously you can add some text as well. You can make some annotations. So what I would usually do is go down here and lock the view orientation. So you just go here to save orientation and lock the view. And what that does is, well, it locks the view. So now you can go here to annotate, you can go to text, and you can type in whatever you want. So you can say that this is a curtain wall. There we go. You hit modify, position to wherever you want, and then here you have the leader option, and you can just add a leader like this, and then you can say that this is a curtain wall. and then you can add obviously more useful information to that as well. So I think it's a really exciting way of creating these cool 3D details in order to share more information on your model. Now, if you want to take a look at this project that they have created here, it's actually one of the projects that's on my website. I think it's like 15 hours or 14 hours of content where I show you kind of slowly step by step how to build this very, very complex model in Revit and what you need to think about, what are all the little tips and tricks along the way to creating something as complicated as this that we have over here. So again, as I said, if you're interested, it's going to be the link that's in the description as well as the cards above. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.